out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here's Brady. Allen's got it over the middle. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
Seeing that play and understanding just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running around the NFL nowadays, makes me glad I didn't make it in that league. I would have had a really difficult time.
But now you get to sit up here with me.
Yeah, and that's fun, isn't it? And what a really nice gain right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
Facing a second and two after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
Wait, 20! Down 80! Down 80! Right there.
Brady to throw on second down. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
An early test, two plays in. This is third and two. Brady going to try and throw on third down, and that is incomplete. It was DJ Swearinger right there on the coverage.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
12 yards on the return that time, and it'll be Redskins football now with a first and 10. It's Richardson, and he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. Just a yard on the catch there. It'll be second and 9. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. They'll fake it. Now Smith. And he goes down. It's a Patriots sack. Dante Hightower in there to drop him. And it'll be a loss of about 8. Off of play action. Here's Smith. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 40. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Well, this is a defense that can confuse even the best of quarterbacks with their zone schemes. And here you've got a linebacker that's going to stay at home and just sit down in that zone. And this one basically comes right to him.
The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field.
They were forced to punt last time, and I doubt sincerely that they'll have to punt here because they're gifted with terrific field position.
I don't even want to think about the idea that they would end up punting starting with this type of field position. Neither do they. Great starting spot, great opportunity to run your full playbook. If they want to take a shot here, they can go ahead and do it.
Let's go. On second down, here's Brady.
To the left side, and he's got Edelman.
And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. And they'll get nine there as that sets them up better for third down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
From the gun on third down, Brady. And he'll have his man. That's Edelman.
17 yards there for the Patriots as they've got themselves a first down.
The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good. Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against.
Now Brady throwing on second down.
Quickly to Gronkowski. That's caught. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down.
Go! Go!
Brady looking to throw on 3rd and 2. He hits right, complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. James White, a 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Pats have taken the early lead. And he gets it to make it 7-0 Patriots.
Kowski now out to kick it away. This one taken from the 7. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Now the Redskins offense, they get set to go back to work here. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. So a loss of 5. And it'll be second down.
Moving backwards on first down, never a good thing. What does that do for the mindset on second down?
Well, it changes your play call, definitely, because as a play call, you're advancing yourself, thinking, okay, we're going to get a gain here. Now you've got to go back in reverse, come up with something to pick up not just the yardage lost, but gain a few extra.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Smith. Forced out to his left. Room here to run. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
And it's Smith. He's going to float this one deep right side. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a 4th down. I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence. that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe you want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive. And he gets this away, and look at this. This is a good one. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
The drive starts with a run by White. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Give him 15 yards on that one, and New England has a first down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old-school NFL football. The right side of the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
First down, and they see right through that defensively as he'll be hit and taken down to the backfield. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and it'll be second and 12. They go play action for White. Now it's Brady. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
New England on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12. On play action. Now Brady. Trying for Edelman again. This time he's got it. And he's finally taken down. And it's a big game there on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. In Washington territory now. Here's first and 10. Down at the 31. And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. Looking for Brett. Intercepted. Picked off at the 28. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Redskins touchdown.
Now that was a beautiful play. A pick six. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
What, you mean with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
Hopkins with the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Here comes Philip Dorsett now to return it. Now a hit and a loose football. And the Redskins scoop it. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line. And careless with a football there on the kick return.
And one thing I love about going to practices is trying to get around coaches and hear their catchphrases and what they really emphasize. We haven't been to a single one yet this year where a guy fielding a kick, you don't hear, tuck it away, tuck it away, tuck it away. And this time, they turned it over.
Ball security eluded him. He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
The first carry for the rookie is Darius Geis. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down.
No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. Hogan letting one go deep for the end zone. Fine work by the Patriot D there, and it's fourth down.
And what did we talk with them about prior to the game? Their ability to move the chains, pick up first downs. So far, 0 for 3 on third down. If that continues, they have little chance of winning this one.
And Hopkins' kick is good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So a good kick there, and they put the bow tie on it with 3 points.
And let's face it, everybody wants a touchdown. We know that. But in the NFL, defense is awfully good. You're not going to score each and every time. Be able to knock the ball through the post and take the turn.
By the way, I said bow tie. I meant just bow.
Either way.
You got it.
I just went right past it.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30. And now out come the Patriots. And last time, decent field position through the pick six, obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. On play action, they'll throw. That's Cordarrelle Patterson hauling it in. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. A first carry now for Rex Burkhead. Oh, twisting away. And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
Again, they run with Burkhead. And some room to maneuver. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25. 18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will. Hoyer now. After the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's 1st and 10.
Four down. Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Rex Burkhead, a 15-yard touchdown grab. And the Pats able to cash in for 6. There are several elements to a well-executed screen pass. This one resulted in a touchdown. It had all of those elements.
Yeah, you're so right, because you really need the rush to almost get to the quarterback, almost get to the passer. Then you've got to get the ball thrown perfectly, whether it's to the running back, the wide receiver, whoever the screen guy is. And, of course, the blocking has to form in front to get him downfield for the touchdown.
Now play fake here on first down. Flushed out right. Toward the left sideline, but it's incomplete.
He was trying to get it there to Vernon Davis, the tight end. And it's second down.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit. But over the second quarter, a lot of time to change things.
He'll leave it for Kelly, complete. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. The Redskins on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. Here it's 3rd and 2. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. The Redskins on third down, 0-for-3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This time they face a 3rd and 2. From the gun, Hogan being chased out left. He finds Quick and able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. They go play action here on first down. And almost intercepted. It would have been his second pick of the game. Instead, it'll be second down.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept him on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Throwing again. Hogan setting up the screen to Kelly. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. First down now, but the clock continues to move.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is 2nd and 10.
Watching that body, body. All right, here we go.
Back to the air on 2nd down. Hogan completes it to Quick. And he's going to get this inside the 30. The 15 yards there on the catch and run.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tough for guys trying to get to the football.
And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. To throw on 2nd down. Hogan, he'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. As they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. An 8-play drive to this point. So here's play number 9 on 3rd and 7.
Here we go now. Blue landing.
Operating from the gun. Hogan. Oh, he may have gotten lucky. Tried to dump it off underneath on the check down. Nearly picked. Instead, it's incomplete.
Well, he'd been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally, I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
And for the 2nd time tonight, this field goal unit comes out here. He connected on his first. This time, it's 39 yards away. And Hopkins' kick is good. And that will tie things up as we head toward halftime. So the field goal there caps what winds up to be an 11-play drive.
Well, Carter, that's a lot of offense to run there to only get 3 points. So I just wonder, Are they going to recycle those plays because they were successful in getting three? Or do you go to another section of the playbook trying to find ones that get you into the end zone and get you six?
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. Here's Hoyer. Hits his target, the tight end, Will Tide. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That goes as a gain of 11 and a Patriot first down.
I got kicked out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. With the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
So that one, a hold right guard.
And you understand why offensive and defensive linemen probably go to martial arts schools and work on their hands so often, because that could be the make or break difference on a play. This time you had to grab a jersey in order to make the play happen. Got caught for the penalty.
Hoyer, he's going to rifle one deep left side. And nearly picked off there, almost intercepted. Instead, second down. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. And we will likely not see another play here as they take the knee and head into the intermission all tied. So we have reached halftime in our first preseason matchup of the year, as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, probably not likely to see many starters in the second half as we get back at it underway in this preseason opener. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. They have a chance to break our tie here as we get a look at the first drive of quarter three.
And it's such a tone setter, isn't it? Because both sides trying to seize momentum to begin the half. What do they have dialed up that'll give them an advantage to move the ball downfield?
Let's find out what they have dialed up. Off the play fake, Hogan. Dancing to his left. And he's got his target, it's Vernon Davis. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And he is going to bring this back inside the 20 to the 18-yard line.
You know, if this is the regular season, partner, we'd be talking about just how costly a mistake that was, but probably good for him to get it out of his system right now.
Just hope for him and the team it's not a sign of things to come.
Yeah, without a doubt. Plus, got to worry about making the team. Those types of errors don't help you.
It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And not much on the return there. He'll take it only up to the 9-yard line.
As much football as we watch, we've seen this work many times. In the red zone, first down, take a shot at the end zone, and points result. In this case, though, give credit to the defense. They outguessed them, were prepared, and intercepted the pass.
They'll try to get this running game going with Geis. And strong running there gets this up over the 15-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves them with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. And 10, Hogan. Flush to his right. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Hurry up, here we go.
Off play action. Hogan, nowhere to go. Here he lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
After the sack, they'll come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
And instead, they want to throw it off play action. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And that one incomplete. Had some position but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Now the Patriots gearing up to go now. And they had a nice little drive going last time. Threw the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking we've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? That goes for a gain of 31. The play fake. He'll look to throw. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off by Orlando Scandrick. And he will score. Touchdown, Washington. Here's Hopkins now for the extra point. Extra point good by Hopkins. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And they're going to have very poor field position as he's out of bounds at his 7-yard line. So the Patriots coming out now, and they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, have some fun. All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. That one good for 13 at a New England first down. Down, he'll drop to throw it. He's going to flip one out here to his running back, and he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
So second in inches after that first down completion went just shy of the marker.
Now they'll run it on the toss.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they do.
They'll look to throw. And he couldn't hang on. Would have been their fourth pick of the game. Instead, second down.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. Back to throw now on second and ten. And the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
Anytime a defense can sit back in a zone like that, it tends to create a lot of congestion in the middle of the field. Makes it very hard to slot one in.
Looked like I-4 at rush hour in your hometown of Orlando, Florida. An absolute mess. Big play coming up. Here's third and ten.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. And now another one thrown incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer.
That's taken on the 25. It's a 41-yard punt, but just a net of 31 following the run back. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you content to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
Buying time to his left. Eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. Kyle Van Noy able to drop him for a loss of four.
Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle.
Hey. All right, here we go. Green.
Looking to throw on second down. Hogan. That's caught by Trey Quinn. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains. This quarterback now 9 of 15 throwing the ball, 60%, and it's first and 10. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 10 more there and another first down.
That was a route run not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
A first carry for Samaje Perine. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Back now in Foxborough. It's the Redskins with the football and the lead as we start the fourth. Fake. Hogan, he's going to loft one deep left side here. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Duke Dawson picks it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And space opened up a bit. He's able to take this up past the 10. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards. And it's second and two. to throw. Now they go screen. It's complete. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
Hey, that was a beautifully executed screen pass. They let the rushers get upfield and get the escorts in front, meaning the offensive linemen, other blockers out in front, completed the pass beautifully. So now you've got all that open space with big guys leading the way.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. Call it a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll make it second down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And he rifles one incomplete. Rex Burkhead, the intended receiver there. And it'll bring up third down. I want to go back to something you said in the first quarter about winning.
Is it a positive?
It is a positive.
Okay.
About winning the turnover battle as a visiting team, as an underdog. You were right. They've done just that, and look where it's gotten them.
It's part of the formula. When you go on the road, as you mentioned, being an underdog, winning the turnover battle is a big key, and this one's playing out in this one.
And he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. In Washington territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. The drop to throw. And this is incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight. Unable to find anyone open.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now he'll look to throw here on second and 10. And he'll complete this one to Patterson. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. That catch good for 5. It's third down. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
New England on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This will be 3rd and 5. They'll look to throw here. It's complete to Britt. That'll get them the first down as they get 9 yards out of that quick slant.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10. Back to throw to Michelle with a dump off. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 7 yards on the play, and it'll make it a second down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let them have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. They'll look to throw here on first down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he's able to get this down to the 5-yard line before he's out of bounds. Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll bring up second down. Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. 2nd and 3. Now Hoyer. And this is caught. Touchdown, Patriots. Kenny Britt. Touchdown, and the Patriots are within an extra point of tying this one up. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route ordinarily is probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it was a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
The Redskins offense now, they get set to take over here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Hurry up, here we go.
To throw on second down, Hogan. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So apparently some grabbing of the jersey there on the O-line.
Yeah, just look in the interior, and that's where the penalty occurred.
Now they face a second and long following the holding penalty. Looking to throw on second down. Hogan. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Throwing on third and long, Hogan. Going up top. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
My man's getting a little loose with the football there, right? Interception before, almost had one here. He's got to start taking better care of it.
Yeah,
it
really should have been back-to-back drives with interceptions. He's lucky there. Too far from breaking that. Officially give him 15, and the Patriots take over. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. And they had to go a long way on their last drive to score the touchdown. This time they get at least a little bit more of a cushion with field position.
I have to think that with this field position, after what they did on the last drive, they might want to take a shot right now and try and cut down the length of the drive.
Start the drive. Looking for his running back, and he's got him. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. It's an 8-yard pickup, and it'll be a second down. Time for a break. We'll come back and see how it all shakes out after this. Just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. They got two of the three they needed there. It leaves them with third and just a yard.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
New England on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. He'll drop to throw. And Allen's got it. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskin defense. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. They'll run. This is Burkhead.
And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. The Redskins looking for another timeout, and they get it as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. They'll set up a throw. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. It'll be a gain of 9, and that's going to bring up a third down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way, and really we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
He'll look to throw. Open mid-air. It's Patterson complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. Clock's under a minute. Still plenty of time, partner. They have all 3 timeout.
That means they have plenty of options in their play calling and where they target on the field. They can throw it downfield, maybe even in the middle, and use their timeouts.
A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. As they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. He's going to get it running right. Oh, a nice spin. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
I don't know how many more of these my heart can take, my man. I just don't know. Another big touchdown late in the game. They look like they're in control, but still, there's a chance. Block the extra point, go down and score, kick the extra point themselves. They can pull this one out.
Yeah, but also on the sideline that just took the lead, you got to get your defense ready and the special teams unit for the kickoff coming up.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Got to pull everyone together and make sure they're still focused and aren't already celebrating a win.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And here come the Redskins now. One possession game. Time very much a factor. How does the offense handle this situation?
Well, in a lot of cases, they should be somewhat relaxed. And I know that's counterintuitive because this is a pressure situation. But this is Friday practice every week of the season. You go over this situation. Having to go downfield, limited timeouts, got to get out of bounds and keep the drive going and set yourself up. Defensively, you can't just lay back and let them do whatever they want. So it is a cat and mouse deal here. How much pressure will the defense bring and how much pressure can the offense handle?
We're going to find out. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25.
Green 39! Green 39! Lucky 56! Lucky 56!
Back to throw. He's going to let it fly. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down. Tried to go for the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final 2 plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And nearly intercepted there. That would have been ball game if he had clinched it and caught it. Instead, it gives him one more chance here on 4th down. Down 7, and they've got to go for it here on 4th down. He'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off. And he'll take this back all the way up past the 45-yard line. Agreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
All right, here we go. Green 39! Green 39!
The Patriots in the victory formation as they'll take the knee. A great come-from-behind victory in this one, Charles. And really the difference, obviously, was that fourth quarter. They dominated.
And it has to start with believing that you can make that comeback. Because we've been in games before. We've done games where you just look at one team and realize they have no chance of making it back. Not in the one we just saw here. They did it, and they did it well.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to easports.com. The Patriots winners here at home as we say so long from Foxborough.
Think about everything, man. Definitely when you like you by yourself and you just cruising on the highway, man. Yeah, this got me thinking. On that cap, swerving through traffic, listening to trap. My windows ain't tinted, so notice me. Four braids, Yankee fitted, yeah, know it's me. I'm everywhere comfortable, but I'm still attentive. A young who a money will make offended. I ain't flashy, I'm classy, but I ain't stupid either. Never show up to that's hungry and eager. My brother's keeper, I'm loyal, it's all in my demeanor. A true believer, I believe when they didn't believe her. That's why I don't let opinions affect me. I do what I want to do. If they do or they don't accept me, they expect me to give up. I almost did. Things went from moving faster, slow motion. I was losing focus, stuck on that. It was smooth on the surface, but underneath it was broken. Hoping to find hope in this hopeless world we live in. What you give is what you given. Gotta make wise decisions. Gotta stay tunnel vision. Gotta avoid collision. Keep scratching the surface and keep your palms itching. Gotta pay moms a visit. It's been a while. I've been working. She keep telling me she miss her child. I find myself passing the house, then I spin around. She say I'm always moving. Ma, I just can't sit around. Oh my, cause the cash ain't gonna come to us. When we was down, who gave a dime or gave a for us? So instead of making it hard, I made it fun for us. Make it easy, so when you need it, you just run to us. But it's a lot of pressure. I'm trying to stick and move through this. Fixing these bumps on the road so I can just cruise through this. Living my life on the road, I'm trying to get used to this. And when they throw dirt, I just act like a broom to this. Trying to stay true to this. Even when they lie on me, world on my shoulders, my girl can't even cry on me. God watching over me, the devil probably spy on me. I've been going through some, can't have keep an eye on me. I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture, don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire, I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see a fight of me. I'm sorry. To all my supporters, man, I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. I came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Because there's no days off, there's no days off.
I know it sounds a little painful, but it pays off. Social sites was distracting, so I stayed off. Spoke to God that me and Satan had a face-off. I swear my life was like a rocket, then it takes off. First I plotted, then I got it, couldn't wait long. I put the pedal to the metal, then took the brakes off. And I kept an A1 like the steak sauce. My paychecks used to be a pair of Jordans, and I know I can't afford them, but I went ahead and bought them. Then I quit, started, spent my money on recording. Yeah, the studio was small, but man, that made me a fortune. Made me a fortune, man. Trying to stop me.